Madam President.
Yes, Senator McBride.
Thank you, Madam President. Madam President, members of the Senate, earlier today, something happened in this chamber. Because to reflect on a chain of events, I feel that complicity in remaining silent would agree with you, Senator McKinnon. I want to reread the prayer that's presented to us today, and I am finding great difficulty why anyone would have a problem. The prayer was as follows: I, O God, we acknowledge that our country is facing serious challenges and that our world is in crisis. Give this assembly the courage that is necessary to lead our state towards a more just and peaceful state. Allow the members of this assembly to stand firm for justice as witnesses to you, even if it is against themselves or of their kin or anyone else without any discrimination. Please allow them to control their hearts so that they may bring about and uphold social justice in the laws they make, and so that they are always truthful witnesses. We acknowledge that you are the better protector of them, their kin, the rich, and the poor, that you are well acquainted with everything they do. Amen. Madam President, each of us who are elected to this esteemed body are elected to represent all Delawareans, and as such, we have a responsibility to stand on this floor to let our words and actions reflect that sacred trust. I have never been in the mind to censor words of other members, but I also believe deeply that words have consequences. To criticize the sacred prayer of another religion from the floor of the Senate strikes me as in conflict with everything that we stand for as lawmakers. Muslim Americans fulfill critical roles in our community. They serve in our military, in our intelligence agencies, and in our police departments. They are doctors, profession, teachers, and in fact, they work inside this very building, public schooling. Muslim Americans are Delawareans. I am offended that our guests from the Muslim community today, and anyone else here in this chamber today, would feel anything less than welcome with open arms. And for our guests today to be branded as anti-American ones, when our First Amendment of our country's Constitution explicitly guarantees the freedom of religion, is both ironic and deeply sad to me. I am hopeful we can move past this sad chapter in the body's history. We may not always agree on policy or even politics, but treating others with respect, kindness, and an open mind and open heart